Hej Mohammed.
How are you?
I'm so glad to see you.
Mohammed Abla er en af de mest kendte af de politisk aktive egyptiske kunstnere. For at få ro har han fået sig et atelier ude på en lille ø i Nilen, borte fra det kaotiske Kairos hektiske, pulserende storbyliv. Men på det seneste har Mohammed været tvunget over på fastlandet mere end han ellers kan lide. For han har været med til at udforme den nye forfatning, egypterne nu går til folkeafstemning om.
Beside the architect has to do with culture, which is was good enough. I think the part which about women and children, I mean, I did help a lot in this on those articles.
Selvom det egyptiske samfunds svageste nu er sikret bedre i forfatningen, er forfatningen langt fra perfekt. Det indrømmer Mohammed Abla også. Der er ting, han gerne ville have set anderledes, men ikke havde indflydelse nok til at forændre.
Things like the relation to army and especially the trials, I mean
military court,
military court, and this is something I would like that if we did it not better, it's good enough, but to do it for a certain time, not to put it like this. I mean that we can
forever
yeah, that we can change it in 10 years or something like this, but we couldn't. It was not easy. Yeah.
Mohammed Abla er ikke bange for, at den dybe involvering i et politisk projekt som udformningen af forfatningen vil kompromittere ham som kunstner. Tværtimod mener han, at det har givet ham en ny indsigt.
I didn't lose completely. I was there as an artist too, and for me it is a subject to express in my work. So I didn't lose any. I think I gain a lot of experience. So this will come later in my work.
De intellektuelle, kunstnerne og kulturarbejderne i et land som Egypten rager op. De skærer ud. De forsvinder ikke i masserne. Folk lytter til dem, mener Abla. Derfor er de pålagt et særligt ansvar.
Gives a responsibility for intellectuals and people who deal with culture. It gives a lot of responsibility. They have really to educate people. They have to talk. They have to express. Because you cannot, I mean, you cannot do change without changing of habits and minds.
Trods kaos, opbrud og militærkup, som Mohammed ikke mener er et kup, og alle andre problemer, så er Mohammed optimist.
The Egyptians, they don't respect anybody anymore. They don't listen to anybody.
They have their own opinions now, and they're not afraid to express them.
They are not afraid, and it is different Egypt. So they should think. Sisi should think also.
So in the middle of the chaos, Mohammed, you are actually optimistic.
Yeah. It will be better.
This will be a nice ending to the story.
Yeah, it will be much better because not because of the army at all. Because of the Egyptians. The Egyptians, they did show their real face and they did show that they are able to do it. That they can do it.